This clip will present the enhancements made in ARCHICAD 19 to the conversion of surface and building material attributes during IFC file imports. The IFC Translation Setup Dialog's Import Options panel contains several new options in the material and surface conversion portion of the panel. The Material Import method for IFC Materials field now contains two options. The first option, Create Attributes from IFC Materials, will create a new building material attribute based on each IFC model found in the IFC file. It will also create a new surface attribute based on each color assigned to IFC Materials in the IFC file. Please note that during this process, the building materials are created by duplicating existing building materials. Building materials name and surface attributes, which have been created, will come from the name and assigned color, respectively, of the IFC material. All other fields and settings, including cut fill type, fill pen, and fill background pen, intersection priority, etc., will be the same for the building material from which the new building material was created by its duplication. Material mapping works in conjunction with this option. If, for example, you check the Use Material Mapping checkbox, then map the brown fiberboard IFC material to the plywood ARCHICAD building material, during IFC import, ARCHICAD will create a new building material attribute with the name brown fiberboard, but in the style of the plywood building material. If a building material with a given name already exists in the project file, the building material is not created. In cases where IFC materials are not mapped in this dialog, ARCHICAD will duplicate the building material you define in the Building Material for Non-Mapped Materials field as the basis for the new building materials, and modify the name and surface attributes of those duplicates. In our example above, the brown fiberboard IFC material is mapped to the plywood and building material. So to create the new building material, ARCHICAD first duplicated the plywood building material and kept all its fields and settings, except its name, which became brown fiberboard, and its assigned surface, also named brown fiberboard, which was created based on the color assigned to the IFC material in the IFC file. So mapping is useful if you'd like to see, for example, all imported new wood materials in the style of your project's wood materials, with proper mapping. They will all be shown with the wood's cut fill type in sections. The Material Import method for IFC Materials field's other option is the Override with Building Materials option. When using this option, no new building material and surface attributes are created during the IFC import process. Every single IFC material contained in the IFC file will be overwritten by a building material already existing in the project file. If you check the Use Material Mapping checkbox, then you can specify precisely which IFC material will be converted to which building material in the Material Mapping dialog. The building material defined in the Building Material for Non-Mapped Materials checkbox will be used to overwrite every IFC material that is not mapped to an ARCHICAD building material or is mapped to one missing from the current project file. Coming back to our previous example, the brown fiberboard IFC material is mapped to the plywood building material. In this case, All elements using the brown fiberboard IFC material in the IFC file will be using the already existing plywood building material in the ARCHICAD file. The wall and column elements are using the concrete building material we have defined for non-mapping IFC materials. No new building material attributes are created during the IFC import process, and our attribute set stays nice and clean. The other new option is the Generate Surface Attributes from IFC Geometry Surface Overrides checkbox. Colors in IFC files may be assigned to IFC materials or IFC geometries. This is similar to how ARCHICAD works, where a surface attribute can be assigned to a building material, or it can be assigned as an override to individual surfaces of elements, such as the outside face, inside face, and edges of walls. This option works independently of all the other material and surface conversion options. When its checkbox is checked, it will create a surface attribute in the project file from any color that's assigned to an IFC geometry and not an IFC material in the IFC file. In this example, a color override was assigned to this column's geometry in the IFC file. We can see that during the IFC import process, a new surface named blue was created in the project file, and this surface was also assigned to the column as a surface override, thereby reproducing the color of the column found in the IFC file.